Terrible hurry. Can you tell me the best way to get to Tottenham Court Road?
Well, if you're in a hurry, the best thing to do is go very, very quickly. I'm always being asked for advice, you know. I think it's because essentially I'm very practical. A few years ago, I was driving to a party with my girlfriend when she got a ladder in her stockings. I didn't hesitate. She spent the rest of the evening wearing a fan belt.
I've got a problem. I want some advice. My next-door neighbour keeps staring at me.
Yeah, but I'm your next-door neighbour.
Yeah, and you're doing it again.
Yeah, well, I like it. Stare, 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 stare. Go on, clear off.
You're staring at me all the time.
I'm staring at you with my eyes shut. That's how good I am.
I'll stare at you when you're not even looking.
Oh, I'll stare at you when you're not even here. Yeah, hey, you won't be able to work that one out.
Not a head case, you were staring.
Yeah, you know when I didn't see you yesterday?
What?
That was me staring at you. I used to be an actor, you know. Oh, yeah. I once played the part of Julius Caesar. At one point, as I was being stabbed, I had to say the line, "Et tu, Brute," which translated means, "Don't you start."
You're staring.
I'm staring at you.
Look, we've got to stay awake. If we can stay awake, there's a chance we'll survive. Let's have another round of Trivial Pursuit. Oh. Right, Curtis, who won the Eurovision Song Contest in 1967?
You can't answer, sir. He's dead.
Shut up. Come on, Curtis, have a guess.
He's been dead for 2 hours.
All right, then. Sport, Curtis, who scored the winning goal?
For God's sake, why didn't you put him over the side? You're the captain, aren't you?
That's right. I am the captain. I still give the orders around here. May God rest his soul.
You unfeeling swine.
Look, Curtis is dead.
Yes. So why did you push Nugent over the side?
Nugent?
He was only having a nap.
All right, anyone can make a mistake.
Yeah, but you keep making them, don't you?
What do you mean?
It was you that took on a cargo of 500,000 bags of custard powder.
I didn't know the hold had sprung a leak.
I didn't know custard was aboard till it started coming through the air conditioning. I've never seen so much custard.
You should have closed the watertight doors.
They were no good. We needed custard-tight doors.
All right. Stop going on about the custard.
Custard on the floor.
Look, let's change the subject. You, which sign of the zodiac is represented by a pair of scales? If you don't answer, I'll deduct 5 points.
That's Curtis, sir, and he's still dead.
All right, then keep the points. Now, who's on lookout?
Oh, nothing to report, sir. Except for a 15-mile custard slick heading this way.
Wait a second! There's a ship on the horizon!
Quick, send up a flare. Who's got the flare gun?
Curtis has got it. It's in his trouser pocket.
Well, get it.
I'm not putting my hand in a dead man's trousers. Besides, rigor mortis is set in, you'll never get it out now.
Look, all you've got to do is put your hand in his pocket, point his leg up into the sky and pull the trigger.
Well, I'm not doing that.
That's an order.
Well, I'm disobeying that order, and what's more, I'm taking command of this vessel. I'm relieving you of your captaincy.
All right, you better have the hat then.
Right. Now that I'm in charge, I order you to get the flare gun.
I'm disobeying that order, and what's more, I'm taking command of this vessel. I'm relieving you of your captaincy.
Well, you better have the hat back then.
All right, then I will. Get that flare gun.
Oh, it's too late. The ship's gone.
It's 0800 hours. Who's got the rations?
Nugent has. And you pushed him over the side.
All right, then there's only one thing for it. Ellis.
Yeah. Who wants custard? That's not bad, though, is it?
Oh, that's all right, I can sell that.
I never trust the meat in hamburgers. The number of times I've lent it money. You never get it back. You know all the meat that's not good enough to put into hamburgers? Well, what they do is they get it all together, press it down, and make hamburgers out of it. And the bits that are left over from that are made into suits. Now, there are people walking around wearing beef suits. Beef suits with pork trousers and ham shirts. You can spot them on a hot day. They're the ones sweating gravy.
Excuse me, these photographs you developed for me last week.
What about them?
Well, there's a sort of orange light all over them.
Yeah, but that's your fault for trying to take pictures on Neptune.
Nobody told me.
Oh, go on, clear off. I was watching television the other night and the newsreader said, for those of you who don't want to know the result of tonight's televised FA Cup tie, please turn away from the screen. Leeds 1, Tottenham 2. Here's a good book. Statistics Made Interesting. What am I talking about? It's not interesting at all. Here's a better one. Statistics Made More Interesting, right? Now, it says here that a swordfish has never been known to crash a car. And there are less car accidents in Peterborough than anywhere else. Well, I have never been to Peterborough, but I'm willing to bet it's full of swordfish driving mini metro. It's got to be a step in the right direction.
Well, Father, what do you suppose the new headmaster's going to be like?
Mr. Beaumont? A classics man, I should imagine.
I understand he recently turned down Eton. Said it wasn't traditional enough.
You won't find any lack of tradition here at St. Boniface.
Still, he is a bit of a mystery man. Anybody here know him?
I heard that last year he published a thesis about the influence of Plutarch on Western democracy in 9 volumes.
I looked him up in Who's Who. Apparently, his hobbies include translating classical Chinese into Coptic verse.
Sounds just what we need. A firm believer in traditional values.
Yes, but also with a supreme intellect.
Oi! What Burke left that bicycle lying about and nearly broke me flaming neck.
Can we help you?
Yeah, name's Beaumont.
Mr. Beaumont! Welcome! I'm Fowler, maths department.
Maths, eh? What's 2 and 2?
4.
Good, you'll do for me. Who are you?
Simpson, sir. Games.
Games, eh? Tell me, Simpson, you ever done boxing?
No, sir.
You have now. Come on, everybody. Who else wants to go? Come on, come on. Come on, you're like a bunch of old women.
Women? Oh.
What's the matter with him?
Oh, that's old Mr. Jago. He can't abide the idea of women teachers.
Really? Who are you?
Soper, sir. French and German.
Blimey, your mum got about a bit.
No, sir, I teach French and German.
Oh, I say, well, let's have a bit of French, then.
Bonjour, Monsieur Beaumont, et bienvenue à notre accueil.
That's not French. No, you're going to have to do better than that. The days have gone when you can just make up a load of mumbo-jumbo and pass it off as French. Never heard that rubbish. Is he all right?
I think he's coming round.
Good. Women. Oh! Boy, Fowler.
Yes?
What are 3 sevens?
21.
Yeah, but you had to think about it, though, didn't you, eh? You're all right the adding up. You can't do the multiplication, though. This place is a shambles. The trouble with this school is you don't give education to those who need it the most.
Who's that?
Antelopes. Do you know, in the last 20 years, how many antelopes have passed O-level Spanish?
I can't say.
4. And 3 of them cheated. Right, we're going to have to make some changes around here, I can tell you. We're going to have some new lessons in. For a start, O-level dentistry.
Why would we need that?
See? That could be your own work.
Headmaster, I really must protest.
Headmaster? Me? I'm not the headmaster. I'm the new caretaker.
Caretaker?
No, I'm only joking. I am the new headmaster. Or am I? You don't know, do you? Am I the caretaker or the new headmaster? You don't know whether to be happy or sad, do you?
Well, this is intolerable.
Oh, I admit it, I am the new caretaker. I only come in to get your bin. Mind you, I had you going, though, didn't I? Women.
Well, that's a blessed relief.
Poor old Jago.
Yes.
Imagine someone like that being a headmaster.
All right. My name's Bowman. I'm the new headmaster. My brother, the caretaker, been in. Oh.